Assalamu alaikum, grad 6. How are you all? I hope you will be fine and doing your vacation work with care. Students, our English teacher is present here once again from Allied School with your Oxford Progressive English lessons. Students, we are studying unit number 2. We have studied the chapter number 2 of unit number 2. Today we are moving towards the chapter number 3. You will open your books at page number 36. Here we are going to read oil spillage disaster. It is a correspondent report, a newspaper report from Karachi, Pakistan. In this chapter, the writer discusses the effects and damages of oil spillage in Clifton, Karachi. In Clifton Beach, an oil tanker was broken into two parts. A lot of oil was destroyed, wasted, and it caused a serious threat to the habitats of water. Various species of dolphin and turtles were disturbed. So friends, this chapter has been written in different paragraphs as you can see on the book, but the arrangement of paragraphs on your book is incorrect. So I am going to tell you the correct arrangement of these paragraphs. At first, our paragraph number in correct arrangement is the paragraph at number 8. Second paragraph is the paragraph at 4 number, and the third one is at paragraph number 6. Our fourth paragraph is the 3-1, and the paragraph number 5 is the 7-1. Paragraph number 6 is the first one, and the paragraph 7 is the 9-1. Paragraph 8 is the second one, and the paragraph 9 is the 5th one. So these are total 9 paragraphs, but we shall discuss the summary of this chapter. Come towards the board. Unit number 2, the sea, chapter 3, oil spillage disaster summary. In this chapter, the damages of oil spillage in Karachi have been discussed. This incident of oil spillage took place at Clifton Beach. It caused danger for the species of dolphin and porpoises. A state of emergency was declared by the government of Pakistan. The school near Clifton Beach were also closed. So friends, you will give proper reading to this chapter for further understanding of oil spillage disaster in Pakistan. Now we are moving towards an exercise on our book. At page number 37, there is an exercise. Use the context to explain the following words. Use a dictionary to check the meanings if you need to. The paragraph references are to the correct order of paragraphs. So these words of different paragraphs of our lesson have been given. We will write the meanings of these words. Come towards the board. Number 1, crude oil, fossil oil. Number 2, intact means unbroken. Number 3, pungent means strong and sharp. Number 5, aerial means operating in air. Number 5 means irreparable. It means impossible to repair. Number 6, critical, a state of crisis. Number 7, vulnerable. It means capable of being hurt. Number 8, migratory. It means moving from place to place. Number 9, residuous. It means remaining. Number 10, stabilized. It means made firm. So friends, it was our chapter number 3. That was enough for it. There are no question answers in this chapter. You will solve only this exercise on your notebooks. You will learn these words meanings and homework for them. Students, now we are going to read a poem at page number 41. It is our chapter number 5. Chapter number 4 is not included in our syllabus. The name of our poem is The Tide Rises, The Tide Falls. This poem was written by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, an American poet in the 19th century. The word tide means the wave of water. Rises means comes upward, and falls means comes downwards. So in this poem, the poet beautifully discusses the rising and falling of the tide on the beach. He has created a mysterious atmosphere of the poem by mentioning the beach and seaside, and he also adds to the mystery of the poem by mentioning an anonymous traveler that is unknown for us. So we discuss the summary of this poem, Come Towards the Boat. The tide rises, the tide falls. This poem narrates the scene of the coming in and out of the tide or wave of water along the seashore. The poet talks about different time zones on the shore, such as dawn, twilight, dusk and night time, etc. He also introduces a traveler to add to the mystery of the poem. The mystery is that the traveler is present on the shore in the evening, but why he has not returned in the morning. So students, you will read this whole poem. It is very simple and understandable. You will enjoy it. Students, now we are moving towards the words meanings of this chapter. Number 1, tide, wave of water. Number 2, curlew, wading bird. A bird that walks and flies on water. Number 3, footprints, sign of footsteps. Number 4, ostler, caretaker of horses. Number 5, damp, moist. Students, you will write these words meanings in your notebooks and learn them. Now come towards page number 42 at your book. Here we are going to solve vocabulary. Use your dictionary to find out the meanings of the words in the left hand column. Match each word to its definition in the right hand column. We will match these words with their definitions. Twilight, between light and darkness. Stalls, stables. Hastens, hurries. Neigh, noise which horses make. Shore, beach. Efface, wipe away. Here's another exercise at page number 43. Underneath each head word, write the words from the poem which rhyme with it. The rhyming words means the words which have the same sound. Here, sprawls, falls, calls, walls, stalls, gown, brown, town, bands, hands, sands, law, the. Find 5 words not in the poem which rhyme with each other of the following. Tide, white, white, kite, nay, hay, stamp, cramp, rise, vice. Now we are going to write question answers. Answer the following questions. These are the questions. Come towards the board and start writing their answers. Answer the following questions. Number 1. What time of the day is it? In the first verse, it is twilight. In the second verse, it is night time. In the third verse, it is dawn. Question number 2. What part does the traveler play in the first verse? Here the traveler is a symbol of life on the beach. In the third verse, here the traveler becomes mystery because he has not returned to the beach. So friends, our chapter number 5 has been completed. You will write words meanings and question answers in your notebooks and learn them. You will solve exercises on your books and also learn them. Students, now we are going to study the last chapter of unit number 2, chapter number 6. It It is a poem, an extract from Sir Patrick Spence. Sir Patrick Spence is a very long narrative poem. It is a ballad. A ballad is a poem or song which tells a story. So this whole poem consists of a long story. But here we shall study only a part of this story. Before this part, the King of Scotland orders Sir Patrick Spence, who is a best sailor, to sail across North Sea to Norway, to the King of Norway's daughter back to Scotland for her marriage to his son. Sir Patrick Spence knows that it is a bad time for sailing, but he must obey the king. So Sir Patrick Spence, along with his crew, starts the journey, and when he is returning with the king's daughter, he met a storm, a sea storm. Here the poem starts after the sea storm. This is the poem, Sir Patrick Spence. So we are going to discuss the summary of this poem. Students, this part of the poem tells about the sea storm that tangled the ship of Sir Patrick Spence when he was returning from Norway. Sir Patrick Spence was returning from Norway with the king's daughter and her silken fabrics that were her wedding dresses. In the meanwhile, the storm breaks the anchor of the ship and tears its mast. The sailors wrap the ship with the silken cloth, but to no avail. So friends, the storm starts in the sea. The sailors try their best to get rid of the storm by wrapping the ship with the silken cloth, but the storm doesn't stop and makes many harms to the sailors. Friends, you will study this whole poem by yourself. It has been written in old language, but it is very easy. You will easily understand it. We are not going to study the words meanings of this poem. We are moving towards its exercises. Open page 46. Here is a writing task for you. Complete this grid, some of which has been filled for you. Dialect words. These are old words and you will write their modern English words. Make, make. Good, good. Old, old. Brag, broke. Came, came. Cloth, cloth. Lang, long. Money, many. Mere, more. Fame, foam. Ham, home. So friends, you can see a vast difference between the old English and the new English. There is another exercise at page number 47. Exercise number 2. The apostrophe is used to show that one or more letters have been left out. Complete the following grid by putting in the missing letters. Students, here apostrophe is a comma. Apostrophe is used. You are asked to complete these words. A, all, way, with. Yester and yesterday evening. O, over. O, oh. Of, fight, fast, wept, through. Cork, healed. Fluttered, fluttered. You will solve these both exercises in your books and learn them. Now we are going to study reading for understanding. Open your notebooks and start to write question answers. Reading for understanding. Question number 1. What made the speaker and the last two lines of the of the last two lines of verse 1 afraid? Answer. The thought of a deadly storm made him afraid. Question number 2. How far had the ship gone before the storm started? Answer: The ship had gone 3 miles away when the storm started. Question number 3. What happened to the ship during the storm? Answer: Its anchor was broken. Question number 4. What did the crew do with the fabrics intended for the prince's wedding clothes? Answer: The crew wrapped the fabrics around the ship to avoid storm. Question number 5. What happened to the Scott lords on board of the ship? Answer: Their feet, clothes and hats got wet into the water. So friends, we have completed our unit number 2. Your task is that you will read the chapter readings and poems thoroughly, and you will write question answers and words meanings in your notebooks and learn them, and you will solve exercises on your books and learn all exercises. Allah Hafiz.